Hello, Bee here, and welcome back to Biology. In today's lesson, we are going to look to the sky. That's right, we are going to learn about birds. Did you know that chickens are the closest living relatives to the Tyrannosaurus rex? Would you believe me if I told you that the egg of a hummingbird is no larger than a pea? What about owls? Have you ever seen an owl turn its head? It can turn its head almost 360 degrees, which is important because owls can't move their eyes. Birds make up the class Aves and are beautiful and amazing creatures. They have a unique anatomy that allows them to fly and live their best lives. But before we get started with our study of birds, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to identify the key characteristics of birds, discuss the adaptations of birds that have allowed them to evolve for flight, explain the unique anatomical features of birds. While birds are not the only animals that can fly, they are the only vertebrates with feathers. They also have unique wings and bones that are light and hollow. These three characteristics are part of what makes a bird a bird. Let's start with the light, hollow bones that make up the skeleton of a bird and help them fly. While most animals have solid bones, birds have evolved to have hollow bones filled with air sacs that help keep them in the air. They also have a flexible neck, and some of the bones are fused together for strength. Ever save the wishbone on a turkey? That bone is actually the collarbones fused together. Ever notice the shape of the wings on an airplane? They tend to be curved on top and flat or slightly curved underneath. This shape has been shown to be the most aerodynamic and is based on the shape of the wings of birds. The curved top forces air to flow down and back more quickly than it does underneath the wing, which lifts the bird or the plane into the air. And in an effort to gain more power when flying, bird wings are attached to their super strong chest muscles. You might be wondering, what about the birds that don't fly? Penguins, ostriches, and emus are just a few examples of birds that don't fly, but their wings still provide important anatomical functions. Penguins use their wings for swimming, ostriches use their wings for courting, and emus use their wings for steering when they are running at top speed, which can reach over 30 miles per hour. Bird feathers are used by humans for all sorts of things, from jewelry to fans to the feathered helmets and cloaks that symbolized wealth and power in ancient Hawaii. Birds, however, use their feathers for more practical reasons. There are two types of feathers: contour feathers, which help with flight, and down feathers, which keep the bird warm. Contour feathers are smooth and help to streamline the body surface. These feathers are strong and light and are located on the tail and wings. Birds use contour feathers to help them steer and stay in control when flying. Have you ever slept under a down comforter? Some of those comforters are filled with feathers from geese and ducks. These feathers are soft and fluffy, which help to insulate the bird from the cold. Do you know any vegetarians who don't eat meat but do eat eggs? They would be called an ovo-vegetarian. Are you familiar with the organ of the ovary in animals? It is the organ that produces and nurtures the eggs that then become fertilized in reproduction. As we know, in biology, prefixes can tell you a lot about a word. Looking at these two examples, can you guess what the prefix ovi means? The prefix ovi means egg. What if I told you that birds are oviparous? It means that birds reproduce by laying eggs. Bird eggs come in a variety of sizes and colors, ranging from the ostrich egg that can be 6 inches long to the hummingbird eggs that can be as small as a pea. These eggs have hard shells with microscopic pores that allow oxygen to flow into the egg, while water and carbon dioxide can flow out of the egg. Inside the egg, the embryo grows inside of a membrane. This means that the egg is considered an amniotic egg. Once the eggs are laid, the parent birds use their body to incubate the eggs or keep them at a warm temperature, close to 98 degrees. Birds are the only animals, other than humans, where both the male and female parent are involved in nurturing the egg and young. In some species, the male and female stay together for their entire life, while in other species, they only stay together for one breeding cycle. The next time you are in the meat department at the grocery store, I want you to look for something called gizzards. This is an organ that is unique to birds and in some cultures is considered a delicacy. The gizzard is an organ in the digestive system in birds. It is found before the small intestines, and its main job is to grind the food that the bird eats. Some birds even swallow small rocks and pebbles that stay in the gizzard and help with the grinding. Birds have another unique organ in their digestive system, the crop. As you can imagine, flying long distances expends a lot of energy, so birds have evolved to have an organ, the crop, that is located before the stomach and is used to moisten and store food for extra energy during flights. Finally, we can't talk about birds without talking about their beaks. Due to the lack of teeth, beaks are the tool used for breaking up food. Remember Darwin and what he learned about finches? Through his studies and theory of natural selection, he was able to see that the type of diet determines what beak shape a species of birds has. The final anatomical system we are going to discuss is the respiratory system. As with the rest of their anatomy, birds have evolved unique systems to help them stay light so that they can be efficient in the air. One such adaptation is the presence of air sacs attached to the lungs. The air sacs only store air and ensure that there is always oxygenated air present in the lungs. In the respiratory system of birds, air flows in only one direction. Oxygen flows into the air sacs, then into the lungs, and lastly, out of the lungs. This process allows birds to take in oxygen during both their inhales and their exhales. Think how much faster and farther you could run if you could take in oxygen during your exhale as well as your inhale. In this lesson, we looked at the common characteristics of all birds and the unique anatomical features that allow them to take to the skies. In the lesson PDF, we are going to spend some time looking into more detail at some specific types of birds. In our next lesson, we will be discussing the world of reptiles. Until then, remember that biology isn't just science, it's the way of life. Hey!